हेलो फ्रेंड, माय सेल्फ संदीप एन पल्ले, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग, केवीटी कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग, नासिक। टुडेज टॉपिक इज सिलेक्शन ऑफ बैरिंग फ्रॉम द मैन्युफैक्चर कैटलॉग। सो वील सिलेक्ट द रोलिंग कॉन्टैक्ट बैरिंग। सो इन प्रैक्टिस द डिजाइनर इज रिक्वायर्ड टू सिलेक्ट द बैरिंग फ्रॉम द मैन्युफैक्चर कैटलॉग। फॉर द प्रॉपर सिलेक्शन ऑफ द बैरिंग फॉर द गिवन एप्लीकेशन the following procedure is followed. Initially, we should have some parameters before selecting the bearing. So the step 0 is mentioned here, that is we have to list out the data which is available. So the data available is power transmission, then speed of the shaft, then shaft diameter and the application on which the type of loading depend. So these are the parameters we need to have before selecting the bearing. So step number 1 is calculate the radial load and axial load on the acting on the bearing. Then second, select the proper type of bearing. From this table we can see that there are different types of loadings are available and different types of bearings are available, and it is the combination is mentioned, given some rating, that is ABCD, that is excellent, good, satisfactory. So by checking this we can select the proper bearing. The next step is select an appropriate size of the bearing from catalog. As we know the shaft diameter, we can select the bore diameter of the bearing which is equal to the shaft diameter, and we can start with the extra light series. And we can select a bearing which is having the bore diameter equal to the shaft diameter. So in the table we can see that we have the bearing number or series, then dimensions, bore diameter, outside diameter and width, then capacity, static capacity C naught and dynamic capacity C in terms of kilonewton. So from this we can select the bearing. Then we can find out the standard factor of the selected bearing. So what are the different factors that we need to find? The first one is basic static capacity C naught and basic dynamic capacity C, which we get from the selected bearing. Then radial factor X and axial factor Y. For these two, we need to calculate some ratios. Those are Fa upon C naught and Fa upon VFR. So Fa upon C naught and Fa upon VFR, and then we compare this ratio with value of E here. If it is greater than or less than the value of E, if it is less than E, we need to take the value of X and Y from these two columns, and if it is greater than E, we need to take the value of X and Y from these two columns. Next step, select the load application factor Ka. It depends on the type of application. So we can select the value of load application factor depending upon the element, that is the electric motor, or it is IC engine, or it is a resin compressor. We can take the value of application factor. The next step is calculate the equivalent dynamic load PE. As there are different loads are acting on the bearing, we need to calculate the equivalent load which is acting on the bearing, and which is calculated by the equation PE is equal to X into V into FR plus Y into FA into KA. X is the radial factor, V is the rotation factor, FR is the radial load, Y is the axial factor, and FA is the axial load, and K is the application factor. Then next step is select the life of the bearing, that is L10, that is the rating life. We can select the life of the bearing in terms of millions revolution or in terms of hours. So we have the table. Here we have the application, and for that the bearing life is given in millions revolution. Similarly, in this table for different application we have the life in hour. So we can select the life for the bearing. Next step is calculate the required dynamic load capacity, that is CR. The required capacity is calculated by the expression that is the load life relationship, L10 equal to CR upon P raised to the power A, where A is the equal to 3 for the ball bearing and 10 by 3 for the roller bearing. With the help of this, we can calculate the required capacity of the bearing. The next step is to check whether the selected bearing has the required dynamic load capacity or not. If the bearing has the dynamic capacity C, which is greater than or equal to the required capacity, then the selected bearing is suitable. If it is having less capacity than the required, means that bearing is not suitable and we need to select the next series bearing, and we need to go back to the step number 4 and again we need to calculate the required dynamic capacity and again we need to check it. The next step is calculate the equivalent static load P naught, which is given by the equation X naught F naught R plus Y naught F naught A or F naught R. So the maximum of the two we need to find out it, and after that we need to check whether the static capacity is greater than or equal to the equivalent static load. If it is so, the bearing is suitable. Now we'll see the numerical on this. A single row deep groove ball bearing is subjected to a radial force of 8 kN and thrust force of 3 kN. The shaft rotates at 1200 rpm. The expected life of the bearing, that is in hours, is 20,000. The minimum acceptable diameter of the shaft is 75 mm. Select a suitable ball bearing for this application. So first of all, we'll write down the given data. The bearing is single load deep groove ball bearing. Radial load 8 kN. Axial load 3 kN. Speed 1200 rpm. Life in hours 20,000. Diameter of the shaft 75 mm. So the first step is select the appropriate bearing from catalog. As we know, the diameter is 75 mm, that is a bore diameter required 75. We can select a bearing for the first trial, that is extra light series having the number 6015. So 15 into 5 is 75 mm diameter. Then we need to calculate the radial load and axial load for the bearing. For this bearing, selected bearing, we have the specification, that is static capacity and dynamic capacity. From the table, we can write down these values C naught and C. Then we need to calculate the different ratios, that is FA upon C naught. The axial load is known and static capacity is known. So from that we can get this ratio, that is 0.0896. And second ratio FA upon VFR. Again, we know the value of V equal to 1. Radial load is known and axial load is known. So it is a 0.3750. So we can check this FA upon C naught, it lies between 0.070 and 0.130 in between. And if you check the value of E, that is 0.27 and 0.31. So if you check the value of FA upon VFR having 0.3750, means which is greater than this one, this value, that is E. So we need to take the value of X and Y from these two columns. So radial load factor, so from the table for the value of FA C naught, 0.27 less than E less than 0.31. So we need to take the value from the table, that is radial load factor X for FA upon C naught 0.0896 and FA upon VFR greater than E is 0.56. So X equal to 0.56. And the axial load factor Y, again we have to take the value from the table, but in this case we have to do the interpolation. As you can see, X value is 0.56, it is common, so we can directly take 0.56 in between. But for 0.070 it is 1.6 Y value, and for 0.130 it is 1.4, and our value of FN upon C naught, it lies between these two, means Y value will lie between the two. So we can do the interpolation here. By this method of interpolation, we can get the value of Y, that is 1.53, which is in between 1.4 and 1.6. Next step is calculation of equivalent load. So we can calculate the equivalent load by using the equation xVFR plus YFA into K. So we can put all the value x 0.56, y 1.53, FR 8 into 10 raised to 3, FA 3 into 10 raised to 3, and V is equal to 1. K is 1. So it is coming 9070 Newton. Next, rating life of the bearing, which is given in hours, that is 20,000 hour, we can convert it into millions revolution by this equation. L10 equal to LH10 into 60 into N upon 10 raised to 6. So it is 20,000 hours and 1200 RPM. So we got 1440 millions revolution. Then we need to calculate the required capacity. Then that is the load life relationship. L10 equal to CR upon P raised to the power A. We can put the value here 1440 and 9070. And the ball, for ball bearing A is equal to 3. So we can get the value CR is equal to 102422.36 Newton. Next step, check the required capacity of the selected bearing. Now we required the capacity CR equal to 102422.36 Newton, and whatever the bearing we have selected, which is having the capacity 33,500 Newton. It means which is less than, very less than the required one. So the selected bearing is not suitable. So we have to select the next series bearing. That is the next step. So in the second trial, we are selecting the medium series bearing having the number 6315. So again 15 into 5, 75 diameter. For this bearing, we have the specification, static capacity 76.5 into 10 raised to 3 and dynamic 112 into 10 raised to the Newton. So again, we'll calculate the ratios FA upon C naught, that is 0.0392, and FA upon VFR 3 into 10 raised to 3 upon 1 into 8 into 10 raised to 3, it is coming 0.3750. So we can check this value here. So for 0.0392 means it lies between 0.025 and 0.040. So it lies in between these. So we can again check FA upon VFR. FA upon VFR is, that is 0.37. So which is greater than these two values E. So FA upon VFR is greater than E. So we have need to take the value of X and Y from these two columns. X is 0.56, that will remain same. Only for Y, it lies between 2 and 1.8. So here radial factor is taken 0.56. So, and for axial factor, we need to do the interpolation again. So by doing the interpolation, that is 2 and 1.8 in between, we can get the value of Y, that is 1.81. So it is between 1.8 and 2. Now we got the value of X and Y. So again, we'll calculate the equivalent load by the equation XVFR plus YFA into K. So we can put the value here 0.56 and 1.81. So we got value P is equal to 9910 Newton. Then we can calculate the required dynamic capacity CR by load life relationship. L10 equal to CR upon P raised to the power A. Can put the value 1440. 9910, and here is the 3. The required capacity is 111908.01 Newton. Now we have to check the capacity with the bearing capacity. So the required dynamic capacity is 111908.01 Newton, and the basic dynamic capacity of the bearing which is selected is 112000 Newton. So it means that the capacity of the bearing is more than the required. So the selected bearing is suitable. Hence, the bearing number 6315 is suitable for this application. So in this way, we can select the bearing from the manufacturer's catalog. If here also, if the capacity is less than the requirement, we need to go for the next series bearing. And again, we have to do the calculation and we have to check the required capacity and the capacity of the bearing. Thank you.